In the previous lecture, we saw that amplitude modulated signal can be generated by using scalar modulator and switching modulator. We already saw what is scalar modulator. Now let us understand what is switching modulator and how the switching modulator generates amplitude modulated signal. Switching modulator. It is similar to scalar modulator, only difference is that instead of using diode as a nonlinear device, it functions as an ideal switch. Let's see the circuit diagram for the switching modulator. A switching modulator circuit contains modulating signal source MT for the generation of the message signal or modulating signal, carrier signal source CT for the generation of the carrier signal, diode which functions as an ideal switch, and a bandpass filter for the elimination of the higher order terms. Let's see the block diagram for the switching modulator circuit. At first, the message signal and the carrier signal are given as the input to the summer, which will add the two signals and generate the signal X1T. The generated signal X1T is given as the input to the diode, which works as an ideal switch. Then the X2T is given as the input to the bandpass filter, which eliminates the higher order term to generate the amplitude modulated signal. Let's see the operation of the switching modulator circuit. Let's say modulating signal or message signal is equal to MT and the carrier signal is equal to CT. So the input to the diode is the sum of the message signal or modulating signal MT plus carrier signal CT. Or we can write input to the diode X1T is equal to MT plus CT. And replace the CT as AC cos 2 pi FCT, then X1T is equal to MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT. So input to the diode is equal to XT, which is equal to MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT. Identify this as equation number 1. From the input signals to the diode, the amplitude of the carrier signal CT or AC is greater than amplitude of the message signal MT. So on and off condition of the diode will depend on the amplitude of the carrier signal. Here carrier signal is a cosine signal and it oscillates between positive and negative maximum. So in the positive half cycle of the carrier signal, the amplitude of the carrier signal is greater than 0, then the voltage in the positive terminal of the diode will be greater than voltage in the negative terminal of the diode. Then the diode is forward biased and can be replaced by a short circuit offering zero impedance, and the diode will allow the signal to pass. In the negative half cycle of the carrier signal, the amplitude of the carrier signal is less than 0, then the voltage in the positive terminal of the diode will be less than voltage in the negative terminal of the diode. Then the diode is reverse biased and can be replaced by an open circuit offering very high impedance. So the diode will not allow the signal to pass. These conditions can be summarized as when the carrier signal CT is greater than 0, diode is forward biased, can be replaced by a short circuit and allow the signal X1 to pass. When the carrier signal CT is less than 0, then the diode is reverse biased or which can be replaced by an open circuit and it doesn't allow the signal X1T to pass. So output of the diode or X2T is equal to X1T when the carrier signal CT is greater than 0, and it is equal to 0 when the carrier signal CT is less than 0. Now, it can be observed that the output voltage of the diode or the load voltage X2T varies periodically between the values X1T and 0 at a rate equal to the carrier frequency. So, in order to represent the signal X2T, we need to multiply the signal X1T by a signal which has the value equal to 1 for one half of the time period and 0 for other half of the time period, or the duty cycle of the signal multiplied with the signal X1T is equal to 50%. This type of signal is actually known as periodic pulse train. Here it is denoted by PT. So X2T is equal to X1T into PT, and if we put the value of X1T, then it can be written as X2T is equal to MT plus AC cos 2 pi FCT into PT. Identify this as equation number 2. So PT is a periodic pulse train having the duty cycle equal to 1 half cycle period or T0 by 2, where T0 is the time period which is equal to 1 by FC. Then we can represent this periodic pulse train in Fourier series as PT is equal to half plus 2 by pi into summation from n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2n minus 1 into cos 2 pi into 2n minus 1 into fc into t. Identify this as equation number 3. By the simplification in the summation term, then pt is equal to half plus 2 by pi cos 2 pi fct plus 2 by pi minus 1 by 3 cos 6 pi fct plus 2 by pi into 1 by 5 cos 10 pi fct until infinity. Further simplification in the periodic pulse train can be performed. Then periodic pulse train pt is equal to half plus 2 by pi into cos 2 pi fct minus 2 by 3 pi into cos 6 pi fct plus 2 by 5 pi into cos 10 pi fct until infinity. So we can simplify this periodic pulse train as pt is equal to half plus 2 by pi cos 2 pi fct plus odd harmonic terms. Identify this equation as equation number 4. So from the equation 2 and the equation 3, if we put the value of x1t and pt in the equation of x2t, then x2t will become x2t is equal to mt plus ac into cos 2 pi fct into periodic pulse train or half into 2 by pi summation from n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2 n minus 1 into cos 2 pi 2 n minus 1 fct. And this periodic pulse train can be simplified into odd harmonic terms. Then x2t is equal to mt plus ac cos 2 pi fct into 1 plus 2 by pi cos 2 pi fct minus 2 by thrice pi cos 6 pi fct plus until infinity. Now if we multiply mt and ac cos 2 pi fct with the terms, then it will become x2t is equal to mt divided by 2 plus ac divided by 2 into cos 2 pi fct plus 2 into mt divided by pi cos 2 pi fct plus 2 into ac divided by pi cos square 2 pi fct until infinity. Identify this equation as equation number 5. Here mt by 2 is the scaled modulating signal, ac divided by 2 cos 2 pi fct is the scaled carrier signal, 2 into mt divided by pi into cos 2 pi fct is the amplitude modulated signal with sidebands, 2 into ac divided by pi cos square 2 pi fct is the squared carrier signal. In this equation, the required terms are 2 and 3, so the desired signal can be obtained by passing this output through a bandpass filter. After passing the output signal x2t through a bandpass filter, xt is equal to ac by 2 cos 2 pi fct plus 2 into mt divided by pi cos 2 pi fct. If we take ac by 2 common from the equation, then it will become xt is equal to ac by 2 into 1 plus 4 by pi into ac into mt into cos 2 pi fct. This 4 by pi into ac can be written as ka, where ka is the amplitude sensitivity. Identify this equation as equation number 6. Now equation for the standard amplitude modulated signal is st is equal to ac into 1 plus k into mt into cos 2 pi fct. If we compare this equation with the equation number 6, then we can say that switching modulator generates amplitude modulated signal.
That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.